This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com and the Adrenal Fatigue Center. Today we're going to talk about the role iodine plays in the thyroid glands function as well as adrenal fatigue. Now, iodine is a chemical, a material that is found very, very widely, especially in sea plants such as kelp. Iodine provides the raw material, the molecules, in order to make thyroid hormone. This has been well established. The combination of four iodine molecules makes up what we call a T4. And when each one of the thyroid molecule cleaves one of the iodine, then it becomes less and less. So T4, once the iodine is removed, becomes T3 and continue and so forth. The real workhorse on the body in terms of the thyroid hormones is actually T3. And it is many times, in fact, 3 to 4 times stronger than T4. And its frequency and its volume is reduced. T4 is a pro-hormone of T3, and T3 is the workhorse. So iodine is contained in both of these hormones, and for good reasons. Now, when you have hypothyroid symptoms, the first thing the doctor check is your TSH level, and your free T3 level, and your free T4 level. Now, if your free T3 and the free T4 is low, then the natural progression is to give you a thyroid replacement if there are no other issues found and the doctor is convinced that you have hypothyroidism because of something wrong with a thyroid gland. Now, you can give a T4 that is already made, T3 that's already made, or a natural thyroid such as what we call armored thyroid that has a combination of already T4 and T3. Or you can use iodine as a precursor to help the thyroid kind of kickstart itself if that is the problem. Or at a lower level, just eat more kelp. Now, iodine supplementation can be tricky because if you give too much iodine, the body can go into hyperthyroid, that is too much thyroid. While if you give too little, then you can go into hypothyroid state and continue to be there. Modern medicine seldom use iodine anymore because it is so much easier just to titrate with pre-existing medications such as Synthroid, which is T4, as well and Cytomel, which is T3, or combination, as we talked about earlier. Now, there is a problem if your body is in what we call secondary hypothyroidism. That is an entity where the low thyroid function is not because of the thyroid gland problem by itself, but because of something that is triggering thyroid function to be reduced. Such can be the case if you, for example, have a brain tumor that causes that thyroid not to work well, or more commonly, is a seldom understood as well as passed over a situation called adrenal fatigue. In adrenal fatigue, the body's adrenal glands are not working well, and the thyroid gland tend to slow down as well. So many symptoms consistent with hypothyroid will be visible. In addition to that, antibodies such as Hashimoto-driven can be rise as the body go into an autoimmune problem. So they can be quite convoluted and confusing. The use of iodine in these cases also needs to be very careful, if at all. Small doses can be helpful as testing to see how well the thyroid responds, but large doses can be also considered provided under professional supervision. Now, the U.S. has mandated a very low iodine intake as acceptable by the RDA. But we do know that in many countries such as Japan, the average intake of iodine is close to 50 milligrams, while in the U.S., the RDA is only concerned in micrograms. So there's a lot of controversy in terms of what is the right amount of iodine. forward-looking doctors would tell you that you know, 12 to 50 milligrams should be considered, especially in areas where there's low iodine, because it is so good not only for thyroid but for other issues, especially fibrocystic breast disease. If you suspect that you have thyroid function that's low and you are considering iodine, do make sure that you talk to a iodine literate as well as adrenal fatigue literate doctor before proceeding, so you can avoid many of these possible pitfalls and make yourself worse, because those cannot be ruled out and you want to be careful. At the same time, the proper use of iodine can be quite good, because it can allow you to allow the body to heal itself without the use of medications and the side effects of those medications accordingly. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.